Let's hit the bar first! It's great to see the panties are finally dropping. They've been dropping a few weeks now. I called it about 7 weeks ago that if everybody started to look at the PCR test at the same time, panties would all start to drop. And I see that happening. I just want to make a point that has anybody thought about how not one government throughout history has been able to agree with each other and now they're all singing off the same hymn book? You know, we really, really need to be thinking about this. I'm seeing more and more divide every day. And I think we should maybe make a stance to start to make ourselves as an example. There's a lot of hatred going on, between masks versus anti-mask. We need to stop giving each other shit over this type of stuff and realize that we're all the same people and some people are just confused. You know, we need to educate people. Come from their side. You know, stop feeding that fear-mongering and feeding the hatred. I'm going off notes here. Usually I go off the bat, but I'm going to try and keep myself on track. Another thing, a lot of us are all being branded conspiracy theorists. I say the claim is a virus is coming from China to wipe us all out. The burden of proof lies on them. We are no longer the conspiracy theorists. The debate has been won, but they're hiding. People up in the hill, they're not coming out and answering these questions. BBC, you know.
Fake news.
Every day you're hearing the same stuff. More tests, more tests, more tests. How about more sicknesses? You know, nobody's talking about the real pandemic that seems to be going on. I'm going to ask you all a question. I want to see a raise of hands for anybody that knows somebody who's died of COVID-19. Okay, there's a couple. Okay. I'm going to ask you another question. How many people do you know who has died through mental health issues due to suicide? Where's the real pandemic? You know, this is what we need to be focusing on. People don't see a future at the minute. They can't see ahead. I've fallen victim to this. I've been a victim of mental health myself, and I'll speak openly with anybody about it. You shouldn't be ashamed of this. I've learned to come through it and build myself up and realise who I actually am. But again, today we're going to lift our vibrations, guys. We're not going to dwell on all the negativity. Again, I believe Northern Ireland, there's something special about this whole island as a whole, to be quite honest. And I believe we're going to make the example that's going to ripple throughout the rest of the planet. Okay, guys, now, I'm going to speak about a scam that has kept us at bed for so many years. Because everybody's talking about the COVID-19 scam, and we need to hit some other things in the head as well. Does anybody know about the banking system?
Yes.
Modern money mechanics?
Yes.
Yes, so you all know what the crack is with that.
George Soros is a wanker!
You! Yeah. I wouldn't disagree. Anyway, for you, those of you who don't know about fractional reserve banking, how that works is any bank can actually generate 9